Meanwhile, lawmakers are back to work at the state capitol, but not without a brief disruption.
FOX 31 political reporter Gabrielle Franklin joining us now with highlights from the first day.
Yeah, Jeremy, following a protest in the House gallery today, state lawmakers made it clear they have a lot of work to get done this session, and they plan on working together respectfully to get it all done.
Members of the legislature, we are 3 months into a genocide. 3 months into a genocide.
Colorado's regular legislative session kicked off in a similar way things ended during the special legislative session. Demonstrators calling for change from the House gallery. House Republicans not sticking around to hear their calls. But lawmakers didn't spend much time on the outcries from the House gallery today. Legislators saying they've got work to do.
We are in incredibly challenging times. And we don't have time to waste. We don't have time to fritter away when the challenges that confront our state are so pressing. So let us get to work.
And following months of rising tensions, lawmakers on both sides of the aisle vowed to move forward this year with respect for one another.
We can engage on tough issues without disregarding the humanity and the dignity of our colleagues in this institution or accusing each other of poor motives. To assist in these efforts, House leadership from both sides will develop a consistent rubric to guide our conversations in the well.
May we boldly take those steps and discuss our differences face to face. Come to an agreement, even if that agreement is to disagree, but walk away from that fellow human with a deeper understanding of the opposing point of view.
And lawmakers again noting that they have a busy agenda this year, saying that they are looking forward to working on measures surrounding affordability, education, and housing for the state of Colorado. Reporting live outside the state capitol, Gabrielle Franklin, FOX 31.
All right, Gabrielle.